please welcome on stage the Member of Parliament for Wangsa Maju, YB, Tan Kee Kwong.
Terima kasih, Saudara Fahmi, fellow MPs, our guest speaker, direct attendants, members of the press, ladies and gentlemen. Yes, it is very important to have a structured plan. In fact, this is my fourth term as an MP. We keep hearing, be patient. The DBKL keeps telling us be patient. We've done many studies, you heard about $30 billion at this plan. At one time, DBKL had a department called Plan Indo. Plan Indo. And now, we almost waited in Parliament when the Minister of Federal Territory gave such shocking, sometimes he contradicts himself in Parliament. He said recently when we all cornered him in Parliament, he says, land is very scarce in KL. That we all know, no need to tell us. Then he says, I don't want the sole authority to be given to me as minister or to the Datuk Panda. That is why I'm not gazetting it. Correct? I mean, how can the very reason why we are pressing for it to be gazetted is because to prevent all these type of abuses, lobbying by developers and so on. Now it is very important because recently I went around checking and asked some former DBKL staff. He said, what is happening in KL is shocking. In fact, recently a developer friend told me that in Jalan Kiaping, it's not even in KLCC, it's just next door. A 1.5 acre piece of land is given a plot ratio of 1:18. 1:18, allowing 600 units of very expensive condominiums to be built. And that is the main reason why we need a structured plan. Now, I think yesterday, the Dato' Bata, Dato' Amin, came up with a statement. He says, land in KL is very expensive, don't need to tell us, we all know. And that is the reason why we are not going ahead to gazette it, because only 3 years left. But brother, this has been cooking, boiling in the pot for the past 8 or 10 years. So, and please, the Rakyat's voice is very important. It's not just the Ahli Parliament voice. Because if you look in the recent past, when DBKL wanted to raise its rates by astronomical, I think 300%, the Rakyat reacted. They helped us to sign hundreds of thousands of protest letters. Then, I don't know whether you are even aware, in these economic difficult times, DBKL has bought Wispa BKNS next to the main DBKL building along Jalan Raja Lal. Some smart Alex say, oh, we must have their retirement plan, they say. You want to knock down Wispa BKNS and build another 500 million new DBKL building and link it to the present building. So we all protested, remember, Teresa and all the other MPs, and it was abandoned. And recently, the car parking charges. So, the DBKL, the Datuk Bandar, the Minister of Federal Territory is forced to listen. And I tell you that DBKL has got special staff monitoring all, not only the mainline papers, all the vernacular papers. And they know. Of course, in the end, they are desperate to win back some seats in KL. Now, just one quick before my friend Fabi stops speaking. In my Kawasan, in Wangsa, Maju, along Jalan Gombak, the place called Taman Idaman, there's a Chinese school called Lee Rubber School. Okay, beside it, it was a big plot of land reserved for surau, for library, and so on. Then there's a plot of land reserved for Bomba. The school naturally applied for the use as a car park. It was rejected many times. Then along came one Yayasan Wangsa Perdana to say they want to build affordable housing. And they got it and they are building a condo. So that is because the government plans this and they totally ignore their own plan. That's the reason why we are fighting very hard to preserve and to ensure that the structure plan is gazetted. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Kee Kwong. And now I'd like to invite